Alright, hello everyone. If you've ever worked with Microsoft projects and all of a sudden or for some reason you start seeing these 1.7 weird decimal durations either in your duration column or your remaining duration or the total slack column and it frustrates you and you don't know what's happening, then this video is for you. In this video, I'm going to show you exactly why this happens, how you can prevent that, and some of the tips and techniques that you can use to just work on a smooth, clean duration number of days to make your life easier. Before we dive into that topic, remember for those of you looking to upgrade your skills and master MS Project, we've got an MS Project course that is specifically geared for engineering and construction professionals. So in this course, I'm going to teach you how to streamline your scheduling. We're going to look at real life examples, real case studies. You're going to have a number of templates that you can use. So if you're ready to enhance your expertise and become confident in MS Project, check out our course page in the description. Okay, so the first reason why you may get a decimal in one of your durations is based on a calendar versus settings mismatch. So let me show you what I mean. If you go to File, click on that tab, go to Options, and on the schedule tab over there, you'll see these are the foundational settings that Microsoft Project uses in order to determine your days and the calculation of days. So the default start time that it will use is 8 o'clock in the morning, default end time 5 o'clock, hours per day 8, hours per week 40. So these are the standard settings. Meaning that whatever I enter into MS Project as a task in these settings, it takes it into account in assigning certain values to that task. So let me demonstrate. All right, so just keep that in mind. Click on OK. So have a look at my simple schedule over here. I've got 4 days worth of excavation. I've got bedding, laying of the pipes, etc. It all starts on this Monday. Now, if I zoom in a bit and I go to the hour... to the hours. So there you can see the way in which it creates any task now. So if I enter a new task and I add 4 days, it starts at 8 o'clock. Remember, it ends on at 5 o'clock. Oh, let's just make this one bigger. There we go. So it ends at 5 o'clock. So it doesn't include that 5 o'clock hour. Remember that that's going to end then at 6 o'clock. So it looks as if it ends on 4 o'clock, but it's actually that is an hour up to 5 o'clock. And here you can count, so it's exactly 8 hours, and we've got this lunch hour in between. So this is the standard setting in MS Project, and if you keep on using this and you don't tweak anything, you should be fine, except for updates, which I'll deal with in the next point. So for now, this is important, this is the standard setting. Now, why do we get decimals? Well, firstly, it's when there's a mismatch now between those settings and these calendar settings. So if we right click there and you go to change working time, or you can go to the project tab and select change working time as well, this is where you can tweak the calendar that you are working on and you can change these default working times. And this is typically where the nonsense starts, because mostly certain project managers or the client representative or somebody will say, this calendar of yours is not accurate. We are going to work from 7 o'clock, let's say, on a Monday, and this isn't accurate. So you must go and change that. So if I go to work weeks here on that tab and I click on details, this is where I can now change the specific working times. I can either use the default or I can set my own days or times. And typically a lot of project managers will change this, so they'll say, no, let's put in the accurate time we're going to work from 7, and maybe you're going to work up to 6 or 9 o'clock at night, or you change the shifts, whatever. I'm just going to change one for the sake of this exercise, and then click on OK. And once you've changed that, you'll now see there the problems start, and it usually leads into a loop of death for your schedule, because you're never going to get out of this duration mismatch again, because MS Project is now still calculating the amount of days here using the hours, the 8 hours per day. So if I zoom in again into the hours, you'll see now we start at 7 o'clock on that Monday. So it basically adds an hour, and on the rest of the days we still find still 8 o'clock. But now if you think about it, 4 days initially, we had 4 days multiplied by 8, that gives me 32 hours. Now I've added an hour to this task. So the excavate for pipe trench is now actually 33 hours in total, because I've changed the working calendar. And 33 divided by 8 is where it gets the 4. It's actually 4.125 rounded off to 4.13. And the same happens for the laying of the pipes, because that's also on a specific Monday. It impacts that task, and it also works from 7 and calculates the new duration. And sometimes when this happens, somebody will say, all right, but let's just change this back to 4 days again. So we punch in 4 days there. But what happens now? Again, it uses those fundamental calculations to say, all right, well, 4 days equals 32 hours from this hour. So it'll calculate those hours. And if you go to the end of this task, it ends on that Thursday, the 5th of September. But it ends 3 o'clock or 4 o'clock that afternoon. And then the next task actually starts on that hour. And again, everything is pulled back slightly. And once you start doing your updates, this will also create problems for you and decimals, etc. Plus, it creates this weird situation where the bedding actually starts on the same day that we're finishing the excavation. And is that possible? You know, will the guys do a little bit of bedding for that 1 hour on that day? Usually it's inaccurate. So now you can see you're in this loop now, starting to try and make sense of these decimals or get them away. It's still using the fundamentals to calculate. So that's reason number one. Make sure that there's no mismatch between your working time as stipulated over here and the calculation parameters. That's why for me, I just choose to keep them the same. If you don't have resource allocations on your schedule, let's say you are doing a schedule in construction and you don't have resources that you're going to track, you just want the Gantt chart, then my advice is never, never, ever change your calendars. Don't align them with whatever. If you want to work 10 hours per day, do that. It does not need to say that on the schedule, because you can simply work on a higher level here and just work on days. So on that Monday, Tuesday and Wednesday, you can work 10 hours each of those days. Doesn't matter. Doesn't need to change here. Just keep it. Just keep yourself sane. If not, and you want to change it and you're happy to deal with the decimals, no problem. But that's how you get rid of them in this case. The second reason why it may happen, so even if we match our calendar with the settings of MS Project, you can still get those decimals based on poor update technique. Let me demonstrate. So a lot of contractors do this. Let's say we've got this task now. I've drawn the time now line there. So in other words, the status date is on the 3rd of September. And what they do is they go through the work and they say, okay, this excavation, we're about 70% complete, and they type in 70% there. Let's make it 30%. Let's do that. So now we are saying we are slightly behind. You can see we've only done 30%. So some of the work that ought to have been done hasn't progressed yet. And I want you to notice the fact that we now have decimals again on these actual and the remaining duration. Now the reason this is remember that MS Project uses the following formula: percentage complete equals the actual duration divided by total duration. That's how it calculates it. But when we have those three variables, and one of them is already given, and we punch in another one, it'll automatically work out the third variable. And that's what he does in this case. Because we've got total duration, we punched in the value of 30%, therefore it calculates the actual duration as 1.2 days. So it's simple math, it's a simple mathematical calculation, and that's how we end up with these decimals. So to avoid this, my advice is, as always, to do rather work in whole days. So let's undo this quickly. So where we do an update, I never focus on percentage complete. I focus rather on the actual duration to date and remaining. So in this case, if 2 days have passed, even if we haven't worked on this because it's already progressed, I will add my actual duration as 2, and then my focus will shift to the remaining duration. So if we are slightly behind and we're only going to finish on that Friday, I will enter that in the 3 days there. And each time you'll see how the percentage complete has actually been altered and calculated by MS Project automatically. So you never actually have to add that value or enter that value into that cell. You can simply play around with your actual and remaining. And now you see we remain on whole days. We don't have these decimals. And even our summary tasks are remain in that sense as whole numbers. Okay, guys, I hope you've enjoyed this video. If you have, leave a comment. Please like and subscribe. This helps us to understand how to create new and better content in future for you. And then for those of you who are interested, remember that we've got a MS Project scheduling course that is specifically focused on engineering and construction professionals in this industry. So if you want to go and check it out, it's in the description, the link to that course. See you guys in the next video.